Greetings. Today we will visit one of Indiana's unique natural areas, the Lost River, in Orange County, Indiana. Two of the features of the Lost River are the Orangeville Rise and the Wesley Chapel Gulf. The Lost River is about 87 miles long. It is a large sinking and subterranean stream, as well as an intricate cave system. There are two forks of the Lost River. The North Fork begins northwest of the intersection of Northwest Washington School Road and Lost River Road. The South Fork of the Lost River begins just north of West Chickshanks Road, just west of its intersection with Southwest Washington School Road. The North and South Forks of the Lost River meet a short distance south of County Road 450 north, southeast of Orleans in Orange County. On its way west, the Lost River crosses Washington, Orange, and Martin counties. For about 23 miles of this length, mostly in Orange County, the Lost River flows underground, hence its name. The Wesley Chapel Gulf is a 187-acre tract of land located in the Hoosier National Forest in western Orange County, Indiana. It is named for Wesley Chapel Church, located just to the north. Visitors will find Wesley Chapel Gulf about 4 miles southwest of Orleans and 2 miles east of Orangeville. To find it, drive south from Orleans on Indiana State Road 37 to County Road 490 north about 2.4 miles. A sign pointing towards Orangeville marks the road. Drive west on County Road 490. This becomes County Road 500 at some point for about 3.6 miles, reaching County Road 350 west. The Wesley Chapel Church marks the intersection. The church was built in 1858, originally known as Bruner's Chapel, and has an associated cemetery nearby. The gulf derives its name from the church. Turn left or south. The parking lot for the Wesley Chapel Gulf is about 1/2 mile south of the church. The Hoosier National Forest sign indicates the correct spot to park. A short hiking trail leads to the Wesley Chapel Gulf. It received its designation as a National Natural Landmark in 1972 due to its impressive geologic features. The gulf provides a rare glimpse of Lost River on its subterranean path. Several other karst features are represented in the immediate area of the gulf, including swallow holes, sinkholes, and caves. The Forest Service recognized the uniqueness of Wesley Chapel Gulf and acquired the property in 1996 through a land exchange with the U.S. Gypsum Company. The best time to visit Wesley Chapel Gulf is in the fall after the foliage has died down or during the winter months. From Wesley Chapel Gulf, return to County Road 500 north and turn left or west. County Road 500 becomes County Road 525 north, then County Road 540 north before intersecting County Road 500 west. Turn left or south towards Orangeville. The parking area is on the south side of Orangeville. A short trail leads to the rise. At the Orangeville Rise, Indiana's second largest spring comes to the surface, forming streams that intersect with Lost River a short distance away. The rise is a tributary of the Lost River that rises from a cave into a 220-foot diameter rock walled pit. The stream formed flows southwest to merge with the Lost River. The 355-mile square mile watershed of the Lost River covers 5 counties. This area possesses a large number of underground caves, sinkholes, and underground streams. For more information, contact French Lick, West Baden, 8102 West State Road 56, West Baden, Indiana, 47469. The web is www.visitfrenchlickwestbaden.com. Their phone is 866-309-9139. You can also contact the Hoosier National Forest at 811 Constitution Avenue, Bedford, Indiana. The zip is 47421. The phone is 1-866-302-4173. An alternative phone number is 812-275-5987. You can go on the Hoosier National Forest website and just look for the forest offices, and you'll find the office, more contact information. And you can also contact the Division of Nature Preserves at 402 West Washington Street, room W267, Indianapolis, Indiana, 46204. The phone is 317-232-0209. The web is www.in.slash I'm sorry, start over. www.in.gov/dnr/naturepr. You can find information about the places in this podcast in my book, South Central Indiana Road Trips. The book is part of a 9-book series that details just about any road trip destinations in Indiana that you can think of and many you will not think of. Each book covers a different region of the state, and each covers approximately 10 counties. Destinations include parks, museums, drive-in theaters, bowling alleys, and many, many other interesting places. The books, along with my 130-plus other titles, are found on my website, www.mossyfeetbooks.com. The books are available in ebook, softbound, and audiobook formats. While you're on the website, subscribe to it by registering your email address in this with a subscribe button. I will not email you. However, whenever I post something on the website, you'll receive an email. I post about 3 to 5 times weekly on the site. The posts include podcast episodes, YouTube videos, as well as other content. You'll also receive a notice when I publish a new book, which is about 8 to 10 times per year. Residents of southeastern Indiana can find them at the Walnut Street Variety Shop on George Street in Batesville. The podcast will be available as a video on YouTube on my Mossy Feet Books channel. Follow me on YouTube for more great content about Indiana destinations and United States history. You can also follow me on Facebook at IndianaPlacesInHistory.com, or yeah, just Indiana and Places in History on Facebook. If you follow me on Facebook, you will be notified of when I publish new books, usually about 10 a year, and I also post tons of other content as well.